3, 2, 1 start. A friend recently commented that his father, who passed away just a couple of years ago, missed experiencing a pandemic. Full stop. He was born after the Spanish flu and passed away before the coronavirus hit our world. Full stop. Living in times of a pandemic, it is hard to believe that there have been people who had no idea what it means to live at a time when a disease has engulfed the entire world. Full stop. New paragraph. Indeed, as we obsess with how much the pandemic has changed life and will continue to do so in terms of politics, the global order, work life, for obvious reasons. You can take the girl out of sub-editory, but you cannot take the sub-editor out of the girl. It is also fascinating how this past year has shaped our language, or rather the use of it. Full stop. New paragraph. In one short year, it seems some words have become permanently prefixed with self-quarantine and self-isolate, used so commonly that it's hard to realize they would have drawn blank stares if used in 2019. Full stop. In fact, it's hard to remember examples of the use of isolate or quarantine as a verb before last year. Full stop. Were quarantine and isolate used interchangeably as they are now? Question mark. A small admission here. It took the pandemic for me to find out about the origins of quarantine the 40 days ships and crew had to spend in isolation before being allowed on shore in Venice during the Black Plague. Full stop. And for all the scientific progress mankind has made in the centuries between, it seems as if the modes of prevention have not changed much since. Full stop. A quarantine for those arriving at the border is what was in place then, and now to control the spread of an infection. Full stop. But I digress. Full stop. The past year also forced us to venture not too sensibly into the world of medical lingo. Full stop. Specialized terms such as herd immunity, oxygen levels, and oximeters now slip into everyday conversations as smoothly as Insta or Tweeple. Full stop. By the time the first wave hit us, we all had become experts thanks to our smartphones and ample time to read and panic about the coronavirus. Full stop.